Our hymn is number 228.
God, come to my assistance.
Lord, make haste to help me. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. To God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Alleluia.
O fount of light, true light itself, smile down on us as here we pray. May your bright splendor shine on us when shades of sin are cast away. We thank you for your loving care while work and toil have been our lot. And now the day is near its close. Dear Lord, we pray, forsake us not. Though sun declines and shadows fall, our souls draw light from those fair rays. The sun of justice ne'er withholds, on whom the hosts of angels gaze. May all the faults which we deplore be washed away by Christ our light. And may he purify our hearts throughout the hours of coming night. All glory, Father, be to you. Praise to the Spirit and the Son, who rule all things with power supreme, till all created time is done. Amen.
Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone. When the Lord delivered Zion from bondage, it seemed like a dream.
Then was our mouth filled with laughter, on our lips there were songs.
The heathens themselves said, what marvels the Lord worked for them. What marvels the Lord worked for us. Indeed, we were glad.
Deliver us, O Lord, from our bondage, as streams in dry land.
Those who are sowing in tears will sing when they reap.
They go out full of tears, carrying seed for the sowing.
They come back full of song, carrying their sheaves.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains alone.
The builder of all things is God. If the Lord does not build a house, in vain do its builders labor.
If the Lord does not watch over the city, in vain does the watchman keep vigil.
In vain is your earlier rising, your going later to rest. Blessing the fruit of the womb.
Indeed, the sons of youth are like arrows in the hand of a warrior.
Oh, the happiness of the man who has filled his quiver with these arrows.
He will have no cause for shame when he disputes with his foes in the gateway.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come,
now and forever. Amen. The Builder of all things is God. Those whom I love, I reprove and chastise.
We heard with our own ears, O God. Our fathers have told us the story
of the things you did in their days, you yourself in days long ago.
To plant them, you uprooted the nation. To let them spread, you laid peoples low.
No sword of their own won the land, no arm of their own brought them victory.
It was your right hand, your arm, and the light of your face, for you loved them.
It is you, my King, my God, who granted victories to Jacob.
Through you we beat down our foes. In your name we trample down our aggressors.
For it was not in my bow that I trusted, nor yet was I saved by my sword.
It was you who saved us from our foes. It was you who put our foes to shame.
All day long our boast was in God, and we praised your name without ceasing.
Yet now you have rejected us, disgraced us. You no longer go forth with our armies.
You make us retreat from the foe, and our enemies plunder us at will.
You make us like sheep for the slaughter, and scatter us among the nations.
You sell your own people for nothing, and make no profit by the sale.
You make us the taunt of our neighbors, the laughingstock of all who are near.
Among the nations you make us a byword, among the peoples a thing of derision.
All day long my disgrace is before me, my face is covered with shame at the voice of the taunter, the scoffer, at the sight of the foe and avenger. This befell us though we had not forgotten you, though we had not been false to your covenant.
Though we had not withdrawn our hearts, though our feet had not strayed from your path,
yet you have crushed us in a place of sorrows and covered us with a shadow of death.
Had we forgotten the name of our God, would stretch out our hands to another God,
would not God have found this out? He who knows the secrets of the heart.
It is for you that we face death all day long, and are counted as sheep for the slaughter.
Awake, O Lord, why do you sleep? Arise, do not reject us forever.
Why do you hide your face and forget our oppression and misery?
For we are brought down low to the dust. Our body lies prostrate on the earth.
Stand up and come to our help. Redeem us because of your love. Glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen. Those whom I love, I reprove and chastise.
See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. Praised be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who has bestowed on us in Christ every spiritual blessing in the heavens.
God chose us in him before the world began, to be holy and blameless in his sight.
He predestined us to be his adopted sons through Jesus Christ.
Such was his will and pleasure, that all might praise his glorious favor he has bestowed on us in his beloved.
In him and through his blood we have been redeemed, and our sins forgiven. So immeasurably generous is God's favor to us.
God has given us the wisdom to understand fully the mystery, the plan he was pleased to decree in Christ.
A plan to be carried out in Christ in the fullness of time, to bring all things into one in him, in the heavens and on earth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come,
now and forever. Amen. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God.
From the first letter to the Thessalonians. You likewise know how we exhorted every one of you as a father does his children, how we encouraged and pleaded with you to make your lives worthy of the God who calls you to his kingship and glory. That is why we thank God constantly, that in receiving his message from us, you took it not as the word of men, but as it truly is, the word of God at work within you who believe. mode 8.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior.
For he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed.
The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name.
He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation.
He has shown the strength of his arm. He has scattered the proud in their conceit.
He has cast down the mighty from their thrones and has lifted up the lowly.
He has filled the hungry with good things. And the rich he has sent away empty.
He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy.
The promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever.
Glory to the Father and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, to God who is, who was, and who is to come, now and forever. Amen.
Dixit Andrea, Simoni fratri suo, en venimus Messi.
Let us praise Christ, who loves, nourishes, and supports his church. With faith, let us cry out to him.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Lord Jesus, grant that all men be saved and come to the knowledge of truth.
Kyrie eleison.
Preserve our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and Samuel, our bishop, and Jorge, his assistant. Come with your power to help them.
Kyrie eleison.
Remember those who long for honest work, so that they may lead a life of peaceful security.
Kyrie eleison.
Lord, be the refuge of the poor, their help in distress.
Kyrie eleison.
Father Nathan, for safe travels as he comes back to Denver. Pray for Margie and thanksgiving for her successful surgery, and prayers that her for her continued healing. Also for Lizzie Ashfield, who will be having surgery on Friday.
Through the intercession of St. Paul the Hermit, we pray for all those who are called to this vocation in the Church, and especially confide to his intercession our Regina Celi Hermitage and all the projects going on there.
Patrick and Emily, all of our benefactors. Pray for my parents and for Tom and Katie and their intentions, and also for Becca and Mark as they prepare for their wedding on Saturday. Pray for Tim and his family and for a special
SJI students, for the Brothers Mission here, and for the March for Life coming up this week in Washington, for all the preparations and those who will be attending.
We commend to your care all bishops, priests, and deacons who have died. May they sing your praises forever around your heavenly throne.
Kyrie eleison.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Almighty Father, you have given us this strength to work throughout this day. Receive our evening sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving for your countless gifts. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
May the divine assistance be always with us,
and also with our brothers and sisters.
Martyrology of January. Memorial of Saint Honorat, who around 410 at Lehan established a monastic observance of Eastern inspiration. Beginners were formed in a Cenobitic monastery, whereas the more advanced monks were able to lead a semi-eremitical life in cells spread over the island. He was called to devote the last 2 years of his life to being bishop of the Church of Ava. In the 8th century before Christ, the prophet Micah, in opposition to the disorders which brought about the ruin of Samaria in 721, he had vigorously proposed the ideal of the covenant, consisting in doing justice, loving faithfully, and in marching humbly before God. He foretold the birth at Bethlehem Ephrathah of the peaceful king who would shepherd the flock of the Lord. At Rome on the Salarian Way, the year of grace 309, the entombment of Saint Marcellus, Pope, he devoted himself to reorganizing his church ravished by the Diocletian persecution. Certain measures of pardon taken with respect to apostates merited for him the animosity of some Christians who denounced him to the emperor. He was condemned to serve as a slave in his own church, which had been transformed into a public stable. The same day, Saint Bernard and his companions, proto-martyrs of the Order of Friars Minor, sent by Saint Francis of Assisi to preach the gospel to the Muslims, they were put to death in 1220 by the Sultan of Maracca. Elsewhere, the heavenly birth of numerous other saints, whose names are inscribed in the Book of